My name is Doug Colbert, law professor here at Maryland Law School. And I want to first commend DOJ for giving one of the most accurate and thorough reports that's ever been published, certainly in our state, about what happened at the point of people being stopped, searched, and arrested. But I also want to challenge DOJ to go beyond the arrest, because we have a system of justice. And so while the focus is on the police, we really need to focus on what happens after people are arrested. We have to look at the fact that when people are charged with crimes, that they often are going to be facing bail situations, and in order to get out of jail, they're either going to have to pay a bail bondsman or they're going to stay in jail on the most minor of charges for an average of 45 days in our city. And we have to ask ourselves, why is it that the police, granted they have the power to arrest, someone should be reviewing those arrests before they come into the system. Because right now it's the police who are charging people with crime. And that's something that's really unheard of. The police cannot charge the people they arrest. That's the job of a prosecutor to review those arrests. That's the way it's done everywhere else. But the police know that once they charge, they're going to appear before a judicial officer. And too often, judicial officers will set bail. They have some reasons for setting bail, but they have to be mindful of the fact that people do not have the money to pay for bail. So either the bail bondsman gets incredibly wealthy out of this, and believe me, they're one of the wealthiest folks in our state, or people who are going to stay in jail. When they stay in jail, they lose jobs, they're separated from family, they miss school. And so finally, what happens after that is when they get out of jail, then the public has to pay the cost. So we